conservative men. Our like may never ever be seen again. We have land, cash in hand, self-command, future planned. Fortune thrives, society survives, in needy order of lives, with well and our wives.
Sing Hosanna, Hosanna.
In our breeding and our manner, we are cruel. Oh, ye cruel, cruel, considerate set, we'll dance together to the same minuet.
Rivers, but the New York Harbor, which now looks like all of London afloat. I can no longer in good conscience withhold from the Congress my certainty that the British military object at this time is Philadelphia. Happy should I be if I could see a means of preventing them, but at present I confess I do not. Oh, how I wish I had never seen the Continental Army. I would have done better to retire to the back country and live in a wigwam. Your obedient, G. Washington.
What we do rationally. We never would have caught the queen. Why begin till we know that we can win? And if we cannot win, why bother to begin?
They say this king's not of our choosing. Why should we risk losing?
We cool men. Mr. Hancock, you're a man of property, one of us. Why don't you join us in our minuet? Why do you persist on dancing with John Adams? Good Lord, sir, you do not even like him.
That is true. He annoys me quite a lot. But still, I'd rather trot to Mr. Adams, Duke of Bonds.
But why, sir? For personal glory? For a place in history? Be careful, sir. History will brand him and his followers as traitors.
Traitors to what, Mr. Dickinson? The British crown? Or the British half-crown? Fortunately, there are not enough better property in America to dictate policy.
Perhaps you are right. But don't forget, most men with nothing would rather protect the possibility of becoming rich than face the reality of being poor. And that is why they will follow us to the rock!